requests. I will not sign your baby. No. Not even if you brought the pen.
Can I hug you?
Number two, I will not dance for you. Ever. No, no, fuck you. I dance like I'm being shot at with arrows. I have the rhythm of a dial tone.
Right? Yeah.
Because you're white.
Other than that, I will not fucking stop everything I'm doing to film a happy birthday fucking video in the middle of the show for your aunt who lives in fucking Canada or some shit. I'm sorry, I won't. I know you talked about it, but fuck your aunt. But if you have an actual question, I would love to get weird and fucking answer your question. So if you have a question, raise your hands, just like school. I know it's been a long time. You, sir. Would I ever do a duet with Ivan Moody from FightingFaithless.com? Maybe. Depends on the song, and it depends on our schedules. Because I'm very picky when it comes to the shit that I do. I tend to look for stuff that's a little more outside of my comfort zone, I guess, which is one of the reasons why I love doing this tune with Tech N9ne. But if the right tune came up, because I know Ivan, I've known Ivan longer than he's been in that band, so if the right song came up, we'd see what fucking happens, right? Kill. Good question. You, man.
Yes.
Oh God, not you.
Okay, my question is, in the 80s, there was metal came up, and then each generation has made new metal.
Is there a question in my
mind? The question is, where do you see metal going with the new generation?
Okay, good. Okay, good. You know what? I apologize for being a dick.
When
you didn't hear that question, she kind of gave a very elongated history of metal.
Yeah.
And then qualified it with, where do I see the future of metal going? And that's a very good question. There's a lot of fucking bands out there who are kind of flying the flag, like a lot of newer bands who are kind of trying to find their voice. To me, metal has no boundaries, and it never has. I mean, that's the beautiful thing about, like, this is the beautiful difference between our genre and all that fucking pop shit. Our genre has no boundaries because we're not trying to sell anything. We're not trying to fucking make people happy to buy car insurance. We just basically say, this is how I'm feeling. Fuck all y'all. And that's what's beautiful about it. So it's, I don't know, I can't give you an exact answer, but I can tell you that I've seen a lot of the future of what metal holds, as far as like the younger bands concerned. And we in Slipknot and Stone Sour have always tried to carry that on, and I'm very encouraged by it. It's gonna be fucking amazing to see that shit happen. So, there you go.